this bill emanated from the Senate. It was discussed and considered at all levels of legislative consideration. It is passed to this Honorable House, Mr. Speaker, for our gracious consideration to concur with the Senate so that this bill will be passed, and when passed, this desirous academic institution for the Nigerian Army will be established.
Staff College Judge, what they do is like masters after NDA. There's no vacuum this thing seems to create to fill. We're talking of our lean pulse resources. Mr. Speaker, let's do projects, programs, schools that bring out of this quagmire, economically and otherwise. I'm not saying security is not important. Is NDA not fully utilized? Nigerian Defense Academy. Upgrade it if you need be, if you must add the name university. Command and Staff College, Jaji. What do they do? Have you seen their curriculum? They operate like universities. It's a matter of name, nomenclature. And we're now seeking to create another third institution, university. Mr. Speaker, we're not even funded. Are they out of strike? The Nigerian university, whatever. And they also, why are we creating duplicity in the procedure of funds? I'm of the view, and I want to convince my colleagues that this is not the time for this now. We have Defense Academy, that what degree they do, all military training. We no longer go to Sandhurst and all water to train military. We are here. Why critic? This is not urgent. This is not needed now.
Can we actually run this Nigerian Army University properly? That's the question we should ask ourselves. And speaking to the issue raised by the House leader, that the Northeast, because of the times, will require this university. Let me say that whatever that is happening to the Northeast now is temporary. By the special grace of God, this country will tackle that problem. And so, establishing a university is not a temporary project. It's not one that should be done to tackle a temporary problem. Because when we get out of the security issues in the Northeast, what will happen to the university? So let us be a little bit more pragmatic in looking at these issues. By the time we establish Army University, the House should also be ready to establish Navy University. The House should be ready to establish Air Force University. Civil defense will come with theirs. We already have the Nigerian Defense Academy. Please let us strengthen that academy.
This State Army University is located in Borno South Senatorial District with 9 local governments and with nothing less than 2 to 2.5 million population. As you are aware, as a result of Boko Haram insurgents, in Borno we recorded orphans more than 50,000, widows more than 50,000 as orphaned and widowed by Boko Haram insurgents. And one of the cardinal principles of Boko Haram is to discourage Western education. And we want to show to them and prove to them that we are not only maintaining the spirit of Western education we have, but we are trying to improve in order to prove them wrong with their philosophy of going against Western education. Secondly, we want to plead with you. This area where this university is going to be sited is the area that is relatively peaceful, where even people from the displaced communities may wish to go and have their studies there. So please, I am particularly pleading to our honorable colleagues to consider us. We are in a serious problem in this country. Please, and please, I repeat the word please, to assist us so that at the end of the day, this bill will see the light of the day and be carried. Please, thank you.
It is important that we should be very pragmatic in our leadership. We should be selfless, we should be considerate, and we should not be sentimental. And look, just look at in Nigeria, how many universities we have. We have over 200 or 300. I don't have the real figures. And we have only one in Maiduguri. and now the second one in Borno State, and now the second one in Borno State. Honorable members, some members are trying to truncate that university. I don't think it is a good leadership. We have to look at it. We have to be selfish. We have to look at the reasons, the objectives of this university, and support it. Because I'm sure nobody is happy. Nobody is happy with what is happening in the Northeast or in Borno State today. And if all these people that we are, all these boys that are in Boko Haram, they are educated to the university level, I don't think any one of them can be in Boko Haram.
Two-thirds as civilian, they are not actually military. And these are some of the issues we also have to tax ourselves. Institutions are created through executive fiat. The latter we are asked to come and legalize. Most of the institutions that are created in these past 4 years were without legislative input. A permanent secretary can influence a university in his place, and the speaker may not be able to do that. So I don't know, this thing we have to sit down and ask ourselves. They will sit down in the ministry, create institution, and they will now ask us to come and make a legislation legalizing the existence. So sir, I want to appeal to our people. The military school is already on. I don't see what magic we will do now to truncate the continued existence of the institution.
It's important for this university to go, because training is very key to the growth of any security agency. In fact, Mr. Speaker, today, if you are not well trained as a security agency, either army, civil defense, police, and whatever, we will be having issues. We know that the army, by its duty, is supposed to strictly contain the territorial integrity of the country, either by air or by sea or by land. But, Mr. Speaker, because Section 27, Subsection 2 of the Constitution allowed the President to invite the army when there are internal security issues, just as we have. Today, the internal security matter is so much that we need our army officers and personnel to be trained and be updated. We are talking of having technology. You cannot have just technology without having the people being trained to handle this technology. So I appeal to my colleagues that they should allow this Army University, this particular bill to pass, because today, only on today's order paper, sir, we have six bills that seeks to establish either a university or a polytechnic or a college of education just today, just not to mention the one that has passed. So I therefore want to appeal to my colleagues that they should please understand with us.
Bills on our rules,
what's the point of order? What page?
I'm trying to get it from my report. Presentation of bills.
Huh?
Presentation of bills. I'm trying to get to it.
Yeah, what page? Please just direct us to the order.
I can't find the page, but I'm not trying to work that.
No. You have to. The rule says you when you raise a point of order, you tell us which order point 12, of order, so that everybody else can follow.
Order 12, presentation of bills. I'm trying to get.
Order
12, presentation of bills. I'm trying to get specifically because I'm using what's before me, and it's epileptic. So. His presentation of bills, said compendium of the bill to be done. I'm now hearing that the school is even ongoing. Who funded it? Who approved it? He said if you are at the third level. So if he had presented some documents, that would have given us a compendium to know what to argue. But as we speak now, we don't even know the status of the school. We are being informed right now that the school is ongoing at the third year. So who funded it? It calls for budgeting. How did they fund it? What's the budget? So we are now not known what we are doing. We need to know the compendium, the status, and all whatnot. We are being confronted right now that the school is even built. Who built, Mr. Speaker? Did you budget for it? And all whatnot.
That's my point.
So I'm suggesting that we step it down to have the compendium and to know exactly so we can do the needful. That's what I'm suggesting.
I agree with you on the point of order of compendium of bills to allow us understand what it involves. But I don't think at this point we should step down this bill, because I have sat here with several bills on polytechnics, on universities, of technological colleges. Not once would we raise or ask for compendium of bills. We more or less, in silence, suspended that portion of this. Not that it should continue. So I don't want us to to pick and choose when we ask for compendium, when we don't ask for compendium. Your point of order is noted, it's in order. But for the sake of this bill, let us moving forward note the point of order that we require compendium of bills. It will take Honorable Gimba, then Chairman Amioke, Honorable Bago, and then we'll put the question. Honorable Bago, you...
My view on this issue is that we are having so much problem with ASUU for now, lingering issues. I'm lucky I was paired with a very experienced chairman on tertiary institutions. We know what's going on. The best way out, I think we should keep about universities issue. Rather, we should privatize them. Concentrate on polytechnics. That's my take, sir. That's my take.
And please say aye. Those against, please say nay. I'm so glad that the work of debating has worked, and even those who oppose the debate for very good reasons have been persuaded. This is what it's all about. So the ayes have it.